Good morning, children. I hope you are safe and fine at home. Myself, Mrs. Archana Pednekar, I will be teaching you social studies in standard 6, social studies, that is history, geography and civics. Now last year in EVS, you had learned about Stone Age Man, okay? Evolution of Stone Age Man to the agricultural activities that flourished on the banks of rivers. History. What is history? History is a coherent account of all the significant events of past in the progress of human culture. Whenever we talk about history, history means past. We learn about past, greatest personalities like Shivaji Maharaj, Mughal Emperor Akbar, okay? So this past stories of great warriors, leaders, we learn in history subject. History tells you the stories of this past emperors, empires, okay? So time, place, society and individuals are the four main pillars of history. Among this, when we talk about place, place is related to geography or geographical conditions. So, geography is an inseparable part of history. We cannot separate geography from history. For instance, our diet, clothing, housing, occupation, in fact, all human life in any region depends to a large extent on its geographical characteristics. For example, the life of people in the hilly region is hectic and strenuous because there's no fertile land there, no vegetation, no agricultural activities. So they have to depend on hunting and gathering for their food. Compared to the life in plains, lots of agricultural activities is carried on there. So people have abundant of vegetation and agricultural activities. So from this, we can find out the such differences in the lifestyle of people of hilly region and those of the plains. The climate, rainfall, agricultural produce, flora and fauna of the region where we live in are the sources of our livelihood. Human settlement since ancient times have flourished on the banks of rivers. You have learned about Harappan civilization, Harappan Mohenjo-Daro civilization, or Aryans who had settled on the banks of river Sapta Sindhu. Okay? People in ancient past have settled on the banks of river for agricultural activity because of fertile plains. Okay? But sometimes reasons like the degradation of the environment, drought, invasions, etc. leads to scarcity of this means. People are forced to leave their settlements. Villages and towns are deserted. Recently, we are going through the same situation, children. You know, due to coronavirus, people have to leave their houses and go back to their native places. Many people have left the cities and went back to their villages. Okay, so we see many such instances in history. We say that, therefore, there is a close relation between history and geography. Now, next we are going to see is geographical features of history. Our country, India, extends far and wide. At its north lie the Himalayas, to the east, the Bay of Bengal, to the west, the Arabian Sea, and to the south, the Indian Ocean. Except the islands of Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep. The rest of our country is contiguous. But when we talk about these regions, so it refers to as ancient India. So we must take into consideration that before 1947, today's Pakistan and Bangladesh were also a part of India. The following regions are seen to be important when we look at the course of Indian history. The first is the Himalayas, second, the plains of Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra rivers, third, the Thar Desert, fourth, the Deccan Plateau, fifth, the coastal regions, and sixth, the islands in the sea. Now look at the map. I will repeat all these regions again. First, the Himalayas. Second, the plains of Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra rivers. Third, the Thar Desert. Fourth, the Deccan Plateau. Fifth, the coastal regions. Sixth, the islands in the sea. Now first we'll look, see the Himalayas. Himalayas, the Hindu Kush and the Himalaya ranges. It has created an impenetrable wall on the northern side of Indian subcontinent. This wall has separated the Indian subcontinent from the desert of Central Asia. Then there is a land route through the Skyborn and Golan passes in the Hindu Kush mountain. This route was connected to the ancient trade route. The trade route from China also passes through the Central Asia and reached Arabia. This trade route was also known as Silk Road or Silk Road. Silk was the main commodity which was exported to the Western countries using this road. Many foreign invaders entered ancient India through this route. Our next region is the plains of the Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra. Now this region consists of Ganga, Sindhu, Brahmaputra. These are the rivers and their tributaries. This region extends from Sindh, Punjab in the west to the present day Bangladesh in the east. We know about Harappan civilization. The earliest Harappan civilization has flourished on the banks of these rivers. Not only this, but even the states and empires of ancient India emerged here. Now we'll go to the next topic, that is the Thar Desert. Look at the map, children. Now, our next region is the Thar Desert. Thar Desert spreads across Rajasthan, Haryana, and some parts of Gujarat. A part of desert lies in present Pakistan. The desert has the Satluj River to its north, the Aravali mountain range to its east, the Ran of Kutch to its south, and the Indus River to its west. The Ghagha River originates in the Himachal Pradesh, reaches to the Thar Desert. It is also known as Hakra in Pakistan. Many sites of Harappan civilization are situated along the now dry course of the river. Next, we will move on to the Deccan Plateau. See, towards the south, we have the Deccan Plateau. The region between the east and the west coast of India tapers off towards the south. This region has the Arabian Sea to its west, the Indian Ocean to its south, and the Bay of Bengal to its east. A region thus bound by sea on all the three sides is called as peninsula. Major part of Indian peninsula is occupied by Deccan Plateau. The mountain ranges of the Vindhya and Satpura are located to the north of the Deccan Plateau. Sahyadri mountain ranges are towards the west. They are known as Western Ghats. To the west of Sahyadris is the coastal region of Konkan and Malabar. To the eastern side of Deccan Plateau are known as Eastern Ghats. Deccan Plateau has fertile land where many post-Harappan agrarian culture flourished. Here in Deccan Plateau, there was a vast empire of Maurya, the largest in ancient India. After the decline of Mauryan Empire, several other kingdoms and smaller empires continued to flourish in this region. The next point or the region is the coastal region. From the time of Harappan civilization, ancient India had trade relations with western countries. So this trade was carried by the sea. But now, due to development, there the trade is carried out, trade and transport is carried out to land routes. But still, the importance of sea route did not diminish. Now we will move on to the next topic, the islands in the sea. Children, we know that India is a peninsula. On all three sides, we are covered by sea. So we have Andaman and Nicobar Islands in the Bay of Bengal. Lakshadweep is a group of Indian islands in the Arabian Sea. So the location of these islands have great importance in ancient times. The manuscript Periplus of Erythraean Sea or the Handbook of the Red Sea, it mentions the Indian island. It has been written by an unknown Greek sailor. Till now, we have learned about all the geographical features of India, which I would like to repeat again. Just look at the map. The Himalayas, the plains of Sindhu Ganga Brahmaputra rivers, the Thar Desert, the Deccan Plateau, the coastal region, the islands in the sea. In Himalayas, we have discussed about Hindu Kush, Himalayan ranges, then Khyber and Bolan Pass, trade route of China and in between China and India, that is the Silk Route or Silk Road. Then I told you about the different rivers in Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra and their tributaries. Our earliest civilization, that is Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa, and the states and empires which flourished in India. Then we discuss about the Thar Desert, which spreads across Rajasthan, Haryana and Gujarat, and some part which lies in Pakistan. Then we learned about the Deccan Plateau, Vindhya, Satpura region, Sahyadri Mountain, Eastern and Western Ghat, coastal region of Konkan and Malabar. Okay, then next region is the Konkan coastal region. We discussed the Harappan civilization, which had trade relation with Western countries, and we discuss about the importance of sea route in ancient India. Then the last sixth point, we discuss about the different islands in India, Andaman and Nicobar Island, in the Bay of Bengal, then Lakshadweep in Arabian Sea, then Periplus of Arthurian Sea, a handbook of the Red Sea, which is also known as Handbook of the Red Sea, yeah, which was written by an unknown Greek sailor. So this all features, I hope you understood all these features or geographical features of India by now. Then the last topic which I will discuss with you is the Indian subcontinent. The cities of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro are in today's Pakistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and India together form the region known as South Asia. Okay, it is also known as Indian subcontinent. The Harappan civilization had spread mainly in the northwestern part of Indian subcontinent. But children, China and Myanmar, these countries are not part of Indian subcontinent, though they are neighboring countries, but it is not included in Indian subcontinent or South Asia. They had cultural and trade relation with ancient India. They have an important place in the study of ancient India. With this, we have finished with the first lesson of history. I hope you all understood the lesson. Thank you, children, for your cooperation.